All right, how you doing today? Today we're taking a look at Nembrini Audio Acoustic Voice. Now this plugin is designed for guitars, acoustic guitars, with either piezo or magnetic pickups that you plug directly into a sound card or whatever, and then you go from here. And we have five different guitars that you can play it through, and different microphones and distance and stuff like that to kind of morph the sounds together, kind of emulate, whatever you want to call it. But today we're going to take a look at this using virtual guitar instruments. Now it's not designed for this, but we're going to check it out with this because you could get some really cool sounds and everything like that, because we do have that feature as well as EQs and compression, reverb, delay, modulation, all that fun and stuff. So let's check it out. Now if you do choose to purchase this plugin, also check out the link in the video description below, because you get a free plugin with every paid purchase from ADSR Sounds. They have different plugins free every month. This is the one for this month. It's two virtual synths and effects filter. Might be different by the time you're watching this, just check the link in the video description for the updated free plugin of the month. Also, please do subscribe to the channel. I have hundreds of videos on my back catalog, all kind of music production stuff, free VST plugins, all kinds of stuff. Hit the notification bell to be notified of new videos coming out, and let's just get right into this. All right, so here we are, Nembrini Audio Acoustic Voice. Now I'm not gonna go to every single feature here, but you'll see I have Native Instruments Contact 7, session guitars, strummed acoustics, loaded up. And here's what it sounds like without this plugin on, just the basic I actually turned off the reverb and such on here and moved the strings up so you're playing the higher notes. But here's what this pattern sounds like. Something like that. And then within the song, and then we turn on acoustic voice and we can start manipulating the guitar, that acoustic guitar. So we're just changing the tone and everything. And of course, depending on your input source of guitar going into whatever guitar mode you have selected here, it's gonna sound different, obviously. And then we have different microphones as well. And then we could position the microphone. We could use the distance of the microphone. I have the modulation, delay, and reverb turned off. Actually, the reverb was on there, my bad. I thought it was off. And then we have compression, a little grit, blend of the dry sound and wet sound and EQ, all that kind of stuff. There's a bunch of presets, but I like playing around with it to dial in my tone. Also notice here there's an input mode, piezo or magnetic. Now that is for the way you're supposed to use it. If you have a piezo microphone on your guitar, select that, magnetic one, pick that. But since we're not actually using any of that, we're just experimenting today, we're just gonna mess around with it, see what comes up with. I kind of like that. It's actually like a mixing tool as well, production/mixing tool to get a different guitar sound from your virtual instruments. So you can get some crazy effects as well here, just experimenting around with different settings. All right, let's test out some other virtual instruments. So I wonder what would happen if we play it on this organ kind of sound here. It should be interesting. So here's the organ without. Let's turn this on, see what happens. Let's turn the reverb off first. So that's pretty interesting. I'm running the organ sound through, you know, morphing it with the guitar, I guess. Very interesting indeed. So that's another way you can experiment with it. Let's just turn that off and let's try something else. All right, sounds cool on drums, not too great or anything, but something cool effect. Let's test it out on piano, see what happens here before. So you can experiment with it on piano as well. That's pretty cool. Get some lo-fi kind of sounds and other stuff like that. Interesting indeed. So there's some cool ideas you could do with this plugin. I'm going to do another video with it using the way it's intended to be used. Anyways, let me know what you think. That is all for now. I will talk to you soon. Bye-bye.